What's really outdated yet still widely used? A lot of school books and supplies. When I went to school, we had world maps that still contained countries that hadn't existed for a decade. The USH, automated clearinghouse, electronic funds transfer system. The same architecture that was used to build the system in the 70s is still in use today, and it still closes down for the weekends to coincide with bank hours. Modern computers don't need to close on the weekends. Graphing calculators in high school math and above. Damn, I miss Mighty 89. Best calculator ever. The way we apply to jobs online. Everyone is using a different system to do the same thing. You'd think there would be a better system for applying to jobs by now than to be filling out an endless amount of the same forms and multiple choice questions. The plus 4 method of measuring bra sizes edit. For those who don't know, it's the method a lot of shops use to make women fit into a lot smaller selection of bras by adding 4 inches onto your under bust measurement. Egg, if you measure 28 inches under bust and 34 inches over bust, you should be wearing a 28E. But if a shop like Marks and Spencer's or Victoria's Secret measured you, they'd add 4 inches and put you in a size more like a 32B. This allows shops to stock a smaller range of sizes, but means that most women are wearing wrongly sized bras. A DD cup is in fact not that large. Fax machines. The US banking system. 3 to 5 days for a transfer. Really? Edit. Yes, we have things like Zelle here in the US, but that is only useful for transfers typically under $1,000. If you send larger transfers, hurry up and wait. I've accepted it and understand banks are using it to skim more money out of the consumer, but come on. It's getting old and is a joke. Edit 2. Of course, small transfers are fine with something like Zelle, but when you need larger amounts, you're screwed. Also, some can't seem to fathom banking at multiple institutions. Yeah, internal transfers are instant, but from bank A to bank B, we have to play the ATCH games. I tried transferring a few thousand dollars recently from one account to another, not the same bank, and it took 4 days, and only after that 4th day did they tell me it failed. Nice. Very nice. The phrase "catch you on the flip side." It's an old phrase back from when DJs would let a vinyl play all the way through, so you wouldn't hear them talk again till they had to flip it. The Space Jam website. Incandescent lights. If I'm doing my math correctly, LEDs use 1% of the energy of them, and they last much, much longer. Edit. Not 1%, but 10%. My math was not correct. Social security numbers. Why do I have a static generated number that is given to me, that I'm told not to give out, but at the same time anyone that pays me needs it to report taxes? On top of that, you can't get a bank account, house, rental, or mortgage, phone, or any line of credit without it. If anyone gets their hands on it, which is easy, then you are F**ked. That person basically has your life's password. Why don't they do one-time codes? Just let you either go on the site or have one mailed that you can keep on hand, or even a batch of them. Then if someone tries to reuse it, it will get rejected. There are several ways to add a layer of verification onto it, but they don't. On top of that, a lot of places use last 4 of social to validate you, which also means hardly anything. And while we're at it, can we please stop using public info, previous addresses, family names for verification? That makes security worse. If a password fails, then you let them in anyway via info they can look up. The US military still uses 8-inch floppy disks on outdated IBM computers to run the nuclear missile systems. It's because they are incredibly hard to hack. The computers are essentially air-gapped and the old IBM computers are reliable. If the military has extra parts and 8-inch floppy disks to transfer the data to avoid degradation, then there's no reason as to why they can't use the same tech to run the system for another 40 years. As 400 computer systems, developed in 1988 I believe, still using this at work today. AA. The program is like 70 years old, and in that time we have learned so much about addiction and proper treatment, but AA has essentially stayed the same. Normally I wouldn't care if AA was some tiny niche thing, but in the States we treat it like, is the best slash only way for alcoholics and drug addicts to recover, but its success rate is about 8% and the WHO doesn't even place AA in the top 25 for recovery programs. I don't really care that AA is behind the times, but I would like it to be seen for the ineffective program it is. Watch too many of my friends and family relapse, or die and go in and out of AA rooms thinking that was the only way to stay sober. Fireworks. I mean, nuclear weapons have been around for ages now. My computer. For my IMS folks, full spinal immobilization for every major trauma. Make sure to like and subscribe for more daily content. Thanks for watching.